So I am walking to Taipa Village right now. I'm a little bit in a rush because I only have like 15 minutes to get there, which should be enough time for me to just walk all the way there. But actually I realized I still need to like take footage of the restaurant from outside, and that will take a little bit of time. So yeah, I need to be in a hurry. I also brought out my hat today. I know I haven't been wearing it for a really long time. I think it's because I felt that it suited my short hair more than my longer curly hair. So I didn't really wear it for a certain period of time until today I decided to finally bring it out again because I have shorter hair again and I like it. I don't know, I really feel like it suits my shorter hair better. And with hoop earrings, so I kind of look like a painter, an art student. I don't know, that's just how I feel like it, but right now I feel like I'm looking like a proper journalist. A weird one, but whatever. So this is my look, very casual, very appropriate for a casual dinner out to interview a bartender, so yeah.
So we picked up a few herbs and spices.
Okay.
So we came up with this 9 signature cocktails. I'll give you one more.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
So I'll just explain you how the menu is designed.
Right.
The menu is an inspiration of like Vasco da Gama, the traveler who left from Portugal,
uh-huh,
and he reached Goa. And this is how the Portuguese colony got famous all over the world, and how there were like small Portuguese colony formed all over the world. And the 9th stop which he took,
okay,
till reaching Goa, is the whole 9 different cocktails of the list.
Ah, all right. Okay.
From,
like, based on the menu, the number, like, 9 cocktails,
which
one would you recommend?
Let's start from the first one.
Okay. Are we going all of it?
Yeah, it's all up on you. If you can survive all of it, I'm sorry.
I'll be dead halfway. Okay,
alright. Let's start with the first one.
We are starting off with Lishbon, which is the first cocktail on the list. And he's gonna make it for me, so this is really exciting. Good.
This is like homemade grapefruit syrup.
Uh-huh.
Fresh lemon, this is gin infused with raw turmeric for 24 hours.
So she'll be here soon.
I'm going to go to the next one.
So I finished my first glass of drink. This guy came in late, but he's here now, having his chicken tikka slider. It's good, right? Okay, so we are heading up now to the dining area. So earlier, the ground floor is the bar. So we were at the bar, heading up to the dining area now to have proper dinner. This is our place? No? Wow! I have paneer butter masala, which is cheese, and I love masala. And then chicken tikka masala, which is one of my favorite Indian cuisines, so this is gonna be a really interesting night. Okay, so I guess a lot of you guys don't know, and I don't think I've mentioned this on any of my platforms on the internet, but I'm actually a big fan of Indian food, so I'm so excited for tonight's dinner because it's proper Indian food, and I haven't eaten Indian food in a really long time after I left the office, because I'm always in Indian spice garden. And I just found out that this place is also owned by the same owners as Indian Spice Garden, so I'm so excited. I'm pretty sure the food's gonna be really, really great. Are you excited to eat with me? Always excited for food, right? And we have a new friend. Hello. Hi. What's your name? Like your name, yeah.
I'm
Menga. Hiya. Le hai Pingakam magazine.
Pantai
Omon. Okay. Basically what we're having is chicken tikka masala in some form of bread. I'm not sure if it's roti or naan, but something like that. And then that is lamb curry, right? It's lamb curry, right? And that's clams. And then we're also having shrimp for tonight. So it's a good mix of meat and seafood and some carbs. And yeah. I'm excited. It tastes really good. So I already had a bite. This is my plate. And it's so far so good. I'm having another cocktail from the menu. So this looks good as well. I'm contemplating whether I should finish the last slice of chicken tikka masala with roti, because I'm tempted to, but at the same time I'm already full. Almost down. And that's down. Oh, there's still. I think so. This is Indian ice cream on a stick. I've never tried one before, so this is interesting. First time to try. And this is Musa Meek. Go for it. Okay, so you tried Mosel so far. I can't see. Focus. Okay, it's not focusing on there. So you tried Mosel and Goa, right? And Mozambique. That's Mozambique. So which one's your favorite so far?
They're all good.
They're all different?
They're
how
all good.
How different?
They're all good.
So which one's the strongest?
Of course, Goa.
Goa's the strongest.
Because it's mostly just water. So
I tried his drinks as well, and so far the one that I really liked is Mozambique, which is this one.
because of the blueberry, so it's a little bit unique. He was telling me that blueberry is usually mixed with white drinks, white liquor, right? But this one's mixed with
based
whiskey. He's an expert on drinks.
So as I was saying, so usually blueberry is mixed with like white liquor, but this is mixed with whiskey, which is a yellow liquor, colored liquor. So it's really unique and I really like the finish.
Okay, so I'm outside of Goa Nights, which is owned by Indian Spice, and Pierre and I just finished our dinner here tonight. It was super lovely. The food is really, really good. As mentioned, I love Indian food, so anything Indian food is good for me. And so this is their cocktail menu. So it's inspired by the travels of Vasco da Gama from Portugal all the way to India. So this is like 9 signature cocktails that they prepared for Goa Night, but Pierre and I have tried 5 of them. So I tried Crepe, Verde Islands, and first one, which is Lisbon, and then he tried Mozambique, Mossel Bay, and Goa. So actually everything is really, really good. My favorite has to be Lisbon because it's special. So I don't know, like the one I tried, Cape Verde and Lisbon, they're both really good, but I think this is more for summer, which is very tropical. And Lisbon is special because it's the kind of cocktail that you will have for like a special night. So it has like special ingredients like egg white. So that's what I really like about it. So it's very thick. He already told you what he liked about the cocktails he had tonight. So yeah, so overall, I'd say it's a really great night, great experience, and I recommend you to try and come here if ever you're in Macau, Taipa, just try it.